part of one of my collections is the gladiolas. It's one of the most asked that I've produced or draw. So I've got one here ready to go. But the first thing I want to show you, it comes with a berry basket. And this is taken from one of my baskets upstairs. I double up on all of mine. So I've cut two of them with double-sided adhesive on the back. And I'm just going to line it up here and put two together. Now, just like the other ones, I'm going to color this with distressed ink and make it into, you know, just a regular basket here. The nice thing about the distressed ink is you can soften areas with a little bit of water later, and I'll show you that in a second. Distressed ink really brings out the weave of the basket here that you can see popping up. Not only is, you know, it comes with the gladiolas, but it's also a good one for a lot of your other flower arrangements as well. I could see this with the sweet peas, or even the roses could go in this instead of on the teapot. Your containers will have multi-functions with your different flowers that you've collected. So I've got it pretty much covered, and you can see it's a little bit uneven, but that's okay. I'm going to take a little bit of a mister and spritz it. So it brings out some highlights in there. Makes the basket look old. It took out some of that, and now I'm going to add a little bit different color over it. I'm just going to turn this over to another side. And where the discoloration occurred, add that in. You know, the more used your baskets get, the more they wear. Either being out, this is a berry basket, so I've picked a lot of strawberries and blueberries from it. So there you go. There's the basket, and then we'll start on the gladiolas. Now, let's talk about the gladiolas itself. It's a six-petal flower, so you will get two dyes. When it says cut three of each, it's because on the stem, there's places for three flowers. The flower only takes one of each of these to go together. So that's a little confusing. So I wanted to make sure you knew that. So we've got the main petals and the other. You'll also get a die that has these little figure eights. And what they're going to be are these little buds up above. And then you can cut three of the stamens all at once. And you've got the stem, which has places for the buds. Now, I've only left places for three. Normally, this is actually, gladiolus is Latin for diminutive sword. And sometimes it's called the sword lily. Now I have one here done where I've added more, and all I've done is cut twice and taken off the buds and put it together. So you can have a longer stem if you're using an oversized card like I've done here, and you can add a lot more flowers. So it just gives you something to start with. If you want to make it even taller, you can. It's just you would take off one of the stem lines. And then, of course, the leaves. So we've got the two pieces for the flower. I've decided to go in purples, but gladiolas come in so many colors and variations. This one I'm going to do quite simply with a deep purple. Make sure I get around the edges. And you are going to color the underside as well. Okay, so I've got the two pieces, and as you can see, I did cut it out three times because there's three places on the stem. Now what you're going to do is put them on your leaf, your molding pad. I'm going to set this aside. And then you're going to use your loop tool. I'm going to grab this, the larger petal. Those are the ones that go on the bottom. And I'm doing just like I do on most of the petals, shaping from the outer edge in towards the center. And then let's do it on this one as well. These are the little smaller petals that go on top. And then all you're going to do is pinch in with your reverse tweezers. And on this one, you're going to roll down the edges, just like we did on the rose when we had those single petals or the three petal pieces. Just makes them look a little bit more natural to have the edges rolled down or softer. On this one, I'm going to pinch in, but then I'm going to grab my medium ball stylus and just round the edge, somewhat like I do a leaf, because these kind of remind me of leaves, and it's easier to do it this way and get that shaping on the end. So let's color the remaining pieces. Here's what's going to make one of those little buds. I'm going to do that in purple to match the flower. And as you can see, there's three places for a bud. So we've got three of them done here. And I'm going to pinch that one in a second. You've got your stamen, which for this variety is just a little bit off-white. I've used a very pale green color to color it. You could have also cut this out of green cardstock. And then for the stem, I've gone just a little bit deeper. Now, I haven't doubled up on this stem, but I did cut it out of watercolor paper because that's a little heavier. Okay, for the stamen, you're going to grab your scissors and you're going to cut these little filaments in half. And then you're going to use your reverse tweezers. And let me put a little bit of glue here. And then you just want to paint the edge with a little bit of glue and roll it up. I'm twisting around the tip and then I'm going to pull it off and then I'm going to like roll it in between my index finger and my thumb a bit. Really gets that to seal in. Then you can take your opposite hand and kind of fluff out the filaments a bit. And I'm going to just lightly dip the ends in the glue and then into some pollen. And I've got the other two done here. For the stem, the only thing you want to do is take your medium ball stylus and soften these areas here where the buds are going to go. So they've rounded out a bit. And talking about the bud, you will put it on your molding pad and use your loop tool to shape the piece. Then take your tweezers, and these are the small detail tweezers, and I put it right in between, and I'm pinching around the tip right in the center there so it kind of comes together a little bit. And then you want to put a little bit of glue right in the center and bring the sides up. And then just set that aside. So here's the piece I started. We did the basket, the berry basket. Now I'm going to go ahead and put some glue on my stem. And I'm just going to tuck it into the basket just a little bit above. I'm going to actually slide that over a little bit there. So I have room to put one of the flowers. Now you can just start building the flowers. You can either take a toothpick and put the glue on, or if you feel like, you know, you're pretty steady, you could dip the bottom in the glue, but make sure you don't get it on the petals. Each one of these, I think I should have told you, should have been cupped. So I'm going to, here's the other one here, and we're going to cup this one. And again, this is going to be where the two petals are, will go, so it offsets it. And then the third one, like I said, you can make this as long as you want. This could have, this was a nice tall card. I could have added, you know, done at least 9. Now you can go back and put the stamens in. It's got a little tiny one here for each flower. And then these buds that have dried, I'm just going to hold the tip and I'm going to put glue on the side here so it'll adhere to the little green part, the calyx that's going to hold them. So doing the leaves, I've actually cut, well, I cut 6 to do this. So I cut the leaf 3 times instead of just 2. The first thing I'm going to do is take my leaf tool on the leaf pad and add that stem line down the wrong side. And then I'm going to pinch up on it. I'm going to add a little bit of distressed ink here, just to kind of shade that edge. And then you can take your pan pastel and accentuate that stem line. Now, if you add a few more of the striations in the leaf to make it look more natural, and then where it attaches to the plant, you're going to pinch with your tweezer. Get that stem line, and then use the medium ball stylus to kind of crimp the edges. Let's bring in a little bit more glue, and then you're going to just tuck some leaves in behind or make sure that one stays within the frame of the there we go. And that's the gladiolus. Like I said, you can make them even go up higher if you like. You can add this one where I cut off the stem. I added one that had more buds on it that hadn't bloomed yet. And do, you know, a beautiful basket bouquet.